88 Air Show, in which the Federal Aviation Agency, we comply with their rules and regulations, and when we say the field is closed, that means that no aircraft, unless it's an emergency, can utilize it.
The core announcer, of course, they're known as the Hollywood Stuntman Premier, Johnny Kazian. Johnny?
Indeed, a pleasure to be here, as always. This air show and this complex setup. That was a short field takeoff by the Harrier, and I mean short field. He couldn't have field, grabbing some sky, grabbing some altitude. He will show you. And now I see the gear extended on it as he comes in. As he wants to hover and slow it down, he will turn the nozzles on the jets, pointing down, and you'll be able to see the exhaust flow, which way it's going. Okay, slowing it down. Well down. Straight down, and a gentle
thing off. once again, he will be going up to his designated altitude for the opening ceremony jump.
World record that we were... He's been cleared. He's on a roll, ladies and gentlemen. Look at this awesome piece of equipment coming down the runway. What a magnificent sight. Buck Rogers got nothing on us. Way, and it will be back later on this afternoon, and it will be making a landing here, and you'll be able to get both configurations, the takeoff and the landing. Okay, the Concorde just cleared the area and
accelerating. You'll notice the feel as they get up. Bob Drew holding us down, letting that 97 Rocky Jones. Now the airplanes start accelerating as they go by. Still, right now, the airplanes are only moving around 85 to 90 miles an hour. So they will watch as they come past. Now, this is not the start yet of this race. This will be, the start will be after they make one complete circuit, and as they cross start-finish line for the second time, that will be the start. Six-lap race, as I've been informed. Hopefully we're right there. And we will mark them off as they go around, try to keep you abreast of what... Very tightly together. We've got one, two, three, four, five, and six. Last place airplane, the all-black one. There, and they now coming around pylon number four. So across the start and finish line first, looks like number 55, the Glass Tiger, with Jim Bumford in the lead. And an airplane already pulling up very high. There goes Bob Drew, number two. Then number 66, Dave Morris. Number 81, Blue Ray. And then Rocky Jones at number 96.
Would you look at the crowded sky? Would you look at the crowded sky?
Yeah.
Now that's a lot of silk. That is a lot of parachutes. On their way down, 58 beautiful Ram Air canopies. Wahoo, what a jump that was, and they joined up. And we will know very shortly whether they set the record. I know they were all in the same proximity, but from down here, it's hard to tell if they were indeed touching arms and hands. But there's a couple of photographers there, and they will have gotten a picture of it. Right on the marker. Oh, yeah. And now, down with another jumper, and flares right on the target area. Oh, what a traffic jam in the sky. Coming down now, another tiptoe stand-up landing. That green smoke on the ground, giving them the wind direction biplane. A Navy leapfrog joined up, and that's what's known as a biplane. Another man in the center of the field, spiraling his parachute down towards the earth. You can see the maneuverability of these chutes. They come downwind, they go crosswind, but when they go in for a landing, it is upwind and into the wind, and then flare both sides. Watch them pull the back down. There you go. Stand up landings. I haven't seen one stumble yet. Everyone's a stand up land target area. All of them coming down into stand up landings. And one with smoke on right up.
So the next aircraft are moving out in their order of lineup now. And how about a nice wave for the 130 as he goes by? Pushed out into their lineup. And again, this group will be
Thank you. Hands on them?
Is he still the playing day?
Okay, Robert, inside snap roll, here's one, and two.
Right, you know. It's like that, man.